we will show you how an OEM ensures technical data package exchanged and sent to the supplier via SCF remain protected continuously. In this demo, the technical data package can be a briefcase or a non-briefcase such as Word document. With Teamcenter DRM, the supplier who is authorized will be able to access the protected data and make changes in the native application, such as NX or Microsoft Word, without the risk of data leakage. The data package with the modifications stays protected continuously and is sent back to the sponsor via SCF. Once the sponsor reviews and accepts the modification, the technical data package will be imported back to Teamcenter. The technical data package is secured throughout the exchange process, and only authorized users can gain access and make changes to the data. This is a typical business process for Supplier Collaboration Foundation, SCF. This secure collaboration workflow with DRM shows you an overall picture of the end-to-end use cases that we are going to demo. DRM secures the data without altering the processes. Throughout the entire SCF data exchange process, the DRM protected data remains secure. We use the lock icon to emphasize that the data is secure throughout the supplier collaboration process whenever there is a file involved. The technical data package exchanges with SCF is protected with DRM from end to end. In the first use case, sponsor Abraham Lincoln will send a briefcase package with NextLabs' protected design to supplier John Tyler. We will start with sponsor Abraham Lincoln logging into Teamcenter. Choose a prepared protected file via named references. We can see the part file is protected as a .nxl file. Let's briefly check the file. Launch NX to check the file. Close NX. Now, we will start a design data exchange event to send the package to the supplier. Attach the assembly to supplier John Tyler. After this, we will grant the supplier modification rights. Save the event and send the package. Verify that the exchange object was sent. As you can see, the message was sent. Now, supplier John Tyler will log into RMD. Access the SCF web portal to retrieve the sent package. Go into the new event, item attachments to download the briefcase file. Let's try to open the file. Downloaded files usually go through Teamcenter Data Share Manager. We will now extract the file. Move the file to the Workspace folder. Now let's launch the briefcase browser. Here we can see that the folder has a check mark indicating that the folder has special permissions. In Briefcase Browser, we will open the briefcase we extracted. Wait for it to open. The briefcase open is completed. In the folder, we can tell that the file is protected from the small checkmark icon, but we will copy the file to the desktop and verify that the file is protected. Here we can see that authorized users have view and edit permissions. We will now launch NX to make some modifications to the object. Cut the sphere into half and then save. Close NX. Synchronize the change from briefcase browser and create a package to send to the sponsor. Now we will start the upload process to get the response package back to Teamcenter. Refresh the event item. We can see that the new briefcase is uploaded as a response to the event. Submit the return package to Teamcenter. We have now shown how the supplier, John Tyler, updated the NextLabs protected design in NX and submits the protected design. Now we will show sponsor Abraham Lincoln receiving the protected design. Teamcenter sponsor Abraham Lincoln views the worklist to check the submitted package and has the option to approve or deny the change. We will approve the changes. Now, we will check the changes on the items sent in Teamcenter. We receive the data from the supplier. Briefly check the named reference. As seen by the .nxl extension, the file has remained protected. Open the file in NX. As you can see, the sphere has been cut in half, showing the modification supplier John Tyler has made. We will confirm that the file is changed and remains protected. To do this, we will download the file to the local drive. We will then check the file rights. As you can see, authorized users have view and edit rights. We will then open the file to confirm Abraham Lincoln's view rights. In the second use case, we will send a non-briefcase package and will grant the edit permissions to supplier John Tyler. As the same sponsor, Abraham Lincoln, send a protected document without using a briefcase. Now, we will check the content of the document. And check name references where we can see the file is NextLabs protected through the .nxl extension. We will send the item to Design Data Exchange event. In the Overview tab, we will change the package type to non-briefcase, meaning we will simply send the document. With this, we will not have to go through the briefcase browser application. Attach the same assembly to supplier John Tyler. We will now grant modification rights to John Tyler and save the event. Now let's send the event. Now the supplier, John Tyler, we'll update the NextLabs protected document in Microsoft Word. We log into Supplier Collaboration web portal as John Tyler to access the document file sent. Since the file is accessed through the web portal, the supplier doesn't need to go through the Briefcase browser application. Download the file and move it to a working folder. Extract the new downloaded file and copy the file to our prepared folder. To prove that the file is protected continuously, let's make a copy of the file onto the desktop. As you can see, the file is a protected NXL file, which only allows authorized users to have view and edit rights to the file. Let's check the content of the document since we have view permissions. Because we have edit permissions, we will make some text changes to the Word file. Save and change the file name to distinguish it from the sent file from sponsor Abraham Lincoln. Now we will upload the modified version to web portal to submit changes. Refresh the page. We can see the uploaded modified Word doc is present. Submit the changes from the supplier side. With this, sponsor Abraham Lincoln should have received a protected document. The sponsor checks the work list and is able to see the modified file. Let's check the file. As you can see, the sponsor has access and can see the changes from the supplier. Now that it has been checked, we will approve the changes. The modified file will appear in the item. Check name references. It is a protected file. The content shows the modifications from the supplier side. For the third use case, we will demonstrate deny access to unauthorized sharing of data package. Sponsor Abraham Lincoln sends a design document to supplier John Tyler through Design Data Exchange. Make sure the non-briefcase option is selected. Attach the data to supplier and grant him modification rights. Send the item. Supplier John Tyler needs to share the file with other users. First, as John Tyler, we will download this file. Once downloaded, move the file to the shared folder, which is accessible by other users who may not be authorized to access the document. Here we can see that John Tyler has view and edit rights on the document as defined by the policy. Another user, Hal, tries to access the same protected document in the shared folder. Hal is not authorized to access the file because he doesn't have the necessary criteria specified in the policy. Hence, he will be denied access. Hal logs into RMD. He accesses the same shared folder and checks his permissions on the file. But as you can see, he has no permissions. When he tries to open the file, he receives an access denied message. With this, we have shown you an end-to-end process on how to protect a file continuously through the SCF process. This concludes the demo.